So good afternoon, Collins. It's great to see you preparing now for the London and the Paris series of the World Rugby tournament. Just you've been playing for Kenya now for over 10 years, doing great achievements, being one of the best players in the world. How is it now that you're wearing Make It Kenya, and what do you feel about, how proud are you for playing for the national team?
I think first of all, it feels good just wearing brand Kenya. I think Make It Kenya coming on board, it's a good thing for the team as well, because I believe sports as a tool, it can be used as a tool to market the country. I think Make It Kenya coming in, it's a huge thing for us as well, for the sport, for the team and for the country as well, in terms of tourism, investors coming in to invest in Kenya. I think just pushing the brand out there and telling people Kenya is a good place to come and have fun as well, business-wise. Just promoting the brand in Kenya.
Fantastic. I remember one of the most beautiful moments for the world, and especially for Kenya, is when you made the highest try in London, and then you came out of the field and gave your father the jersey, and he was very proud. Your mom and dad were there to watch it. What did you feel at that moment as a Kenyan who was top in the world in rugby?
It felt like a great achievement. It just shows how far I've come as a player, and also how far the team has come as well. And I think just breaking the managing to break the record in Twickenham, it was such a good feeling. And just what made it more special is having my parents there. And I think it was such a great time to feel proud to be a Kenyan as well, and also to just playing for the team. I think for the many years we've mentioned, like 10 years, I think just scoring that record, it really felt wonderful.
And Collins, one of the Kenyans and the entire, you know, Africa is behind you in terms of your future. How do you see yourself as a leader in the sports? Now you'll be speaking as Make It Kenya. You'll be speaking at some international conferences representing the country. What about your playing career and your leadership career from now on?
I think just being in the team for that long, you have to assume certain roles. I know we have a captain, but I think in the team also for the guys that we've been there for long, we have assumed the leadership position in terms of mentoring the young guys who are coming through the ranks. I think, like you said, for the future, I think after I stop playing rugby, I think just marketing Kenya, it will be a great thing for me. I think, like you said, speaking in conferences, just being out there selling the Kenyan name.
And Collins, we're very proud of you and for what you are trying to achieve. Do you wish to pass a message to Kenyans in terms of them coming out to support you and the team during the London's Paris, and also into the new season for the World Cup and the new season for 2018 and 19? What are your wishes from all the Kenyans?
I think definitely for the Kenyan who have all supported us, and also who are just coming in to support the team, I think they should keep supporting the team. This team, we still have much greater things to achieve. So with only their support and definitely, like you said, like people coming in, supporting the team, also the fans, I think we can be able to achieve greater things.
So let's make it Kenya, and I wish you success in London.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations for the great achievements. Keep it up.
Thank you very much, Chris. Thank you.